Hi students, myself Ganavi D, Assistant Professor, SDM College, Ujre. In this video, I'm going to give an introduction about active methylene compounds. So you may heard this word, active methylene compounds. So let us see what you mean by active methylene compounds. So active methylene compounds are the class of compounds which contain a methylene group which is directly bonded to the electron withdrawing group, such as acyl group or maybe to the esters group, anhydrides group, or maybe to the cyano or to the bromo groups. So those are called as reactive methylene compounds. So if that methylene, that is CH2 group, which is bonded to the electron withdrawing group, either side of the methylene group, if it is bonded to the electron withdrawing group, so that methylene group becomes highly acidic. That's why if you add any reagent to that active methylene compounds, reaction takes place at that position only. Thus, those compounds are called as active methylene compounds. So, need not to be only a carbonyl group or cyano group. So, any electron withdrawing group, if it is attached to the either side of the methylene group, then it is called as active methylene compounds. So, you can see the example, that is ethyl acetoacetate. So one of the ester it is. So you can see this is the active methylene group. In another example, that is diethyl malonate. This is also a ester. This is the active methylene group. In the methylene group, which is directly bonded to the either side of this bond, is directly bonded to the carbonyl group. You can see that's why this group becomes highly acidic, or this group is like electron deficient. That's why the reagent reaction takes place at this region only. So these are the example. One more example, you can also see the aromatic compounds. In this also, there is a methylene group which is directly bonded to the two carbonyl compounds. So this is also example for active methylene compounds. Now you got the idea what are active methylene compounds. In the next slide, we can see one of the preparation, how to prepare these active methylene compounds, that I am going to explain for only one compound, that is synthesis of ethyl acetoacetate by one of the named reaction called Claisen condensation reactions. Let us see what is that. So it is a reaction in which two molecules of an ester react to each other in presence of base to form a beta keto ester and a alcohol. So it is a beta keto ester. It is a general term which is used for the esters. Okay, so you can see the reaction where two molecules of ethyl acetate, this is one molecule which reacts with another molecule of ethyl acetate in presence of sodium ethoxide, which give rise to ethyl acetoacetate, and the byproduct is alcohol. This is the main reaction, that is the main Claisen condensation reaction. Let us see the mechanism. Okay, so in the mechanism, which involves three steps, in the first step, that is sodium ethoxide, where the ethoxide ion which takes up the proton from the ethyl acetate, in one of the molecule which takes up the ethyl acetate, one of the proton. So as a result, generation of carbon ion takes place. Okay, so in one of the ethyl acetate molecule, generation of carbon ion takes place in the first step. So let us see the second step. So whatever the anion which is generated, that attacks to the second molecule of the carbonyl carbon. So whatever this one generated carbon ion which attack to the carbonyl carbon of the another molecule. So as a result, shifting of this pi bond takes place, you will get the negative charge on this oxygen. That is about the second step. Let us see the third step. In the third step, ethoxide ion is eliminated. So in third step, this generated negative ion, that is unstable, whatever this compound is unstable, as a result this negative charge shift to form a pi bond. Then so by the removal of ethoxide, so you are going to get the ethyl acetoacetate. So mechanism is very simple, which is having very three steps, only three steps. Okay, let us see, that is in laboratory what they do is, in the mechanism we saw that two molecules of ethyl acetate which is in presence of sodium ethoxide which gives the ethyl acetoacetate. In laboratory what they do is, along with the sodium ethoxide, after the addition of that, at the end they do acidification, because since active methylene group, that methylene group is highly acidic, okay, which again may form salt. So to avoid that, they'll add the acid. Okay, if you add acid, once again, which forms the ethyl acetate. That is about the laboratory process. This is about the one of the preparation, that is Claisen condensation reaction. And next, we'll see what is acidity of alpha hydrogen. As I said in first slide only, you saw that CH2 group, protons, what is the alpha carbon containing protons are acidic, I said. So why those are acidic? Let us see in the slide. That is ethyl acetoacetate contain methane group, which is attached by two carbonyl group, that CH bond. In CH2 group is readily ionizable. So that is readily, easily we can remove, because the proton removal forms very stable carbon ion. In the slide you can see that is ethyl acetoacetate. These two are the alpha protons or alpha hydrogens. So by the removal of this one of the proton, this carbon ion whatever generated is highly stable. Okay, this attribute to factors, that is that acidity of CH bond methylene group, which attributed two factors. Let us see what are all those. One is inductive effect and the second one is resonance stabilization. Okay, so in inductive effect, that is inductive effect is caused by the electron attracting power of the electronegative oxygen of the two carbonyl groups, which weakens the CH bond. Thus the hydrogen atom can dissociate to give the stable anion. So in this molecule, by the dissociation of this proton, since there is a 2 electron withdrawing group, so which easily withdraws the electron towards itself, as a result removal of this proton becomes easy, and this because of this electronegative, they withdraws the electron towards themselves, that's why this carbon ion whatever it is generated becomes highly stable. Let us see what is the next effect, that is the resonance effect. That is acidity of CH bond is greatly enhanced because negative charge in the carbon ion is delocalized into carbonyl group by the resonance. So it can be written as you can see. So if you remove the proton, so which gives the carbon ion here, by the resonance this can be shifted to here, this pi bond can shift to there, so which gives one form. So either if it is shifted to another carbonyl here, it forms double bond, which shift to give negative charge on the oxygen. This is the third, you can see. So totally, which undergo resonance, which gives the many structures. By this resonance, that compound become highly stable. So resonance hybrid structure we can write in this way. So by this two factor, one can say this inactive methylene compounds, that is alpha protons. So alpha protons which are attached to the like active methylene group, so those are acidic. So by this two factor we can say those are acidic protons. So this is about the introduction to the active methylene compounds.